Hey guys, it's Mike. Welcome to Autovlog. In today's video, we're taking a look at the brand new 2017 Ford Escape. We're going to do a full tour and in-depth review of this car and also take it for a road test. So let's take a look at the 2017 Ford Escape. For the 2017 model year, the Ford Escape has gotten a facelift. It's not a complete redesign. It's not a new generation Ford Escape. But it has gotten, as I mentioned, a facelift. So it does look different front and back. I'm gonna start by taking a look at the front fascia here. You see the design of the tail light, or the headlights, now has a different type of LED daytime running light there. And to show you guys the difference between the newer model, the 2017 versus the 2016, we'll take a look at that here. Okay, so just to show you guys the difference in the front fascia styling of the new 2017 Ford Escape versus the previous model. This is a 2016. And here's the 17. Now this Escape here has a new feature for this year, which is an appearance package. So as you can see, the exterior color is the ingot silver, and there's a lot of black accents on this Escape here. We got 19-inch wheels in black. Take a look at those a bit more up close here in a minute. We got a blacked out grille. In my opinion, the Escape needed an appearance package, at least as an option, to make it look a little more sporty. It was not available for the previous Escapes from at least 2013 up to 2016. You can get it in the Fusion, you can get it in the Focus, even the Fiesta, the Explorers and Edges and so on. So this Escape here has new 19-inch wheels for this year in black, sitting on 235, 45, 19 tires. Gives it a nice look. I like the contrast between the silver and the black. Got black accents right here. We got black side mirrors. Fog lights. We're gonna move around to the rear of the vehicle. So you can see the taillights for the 2017 are redesigned. At least for someone that sees Escapes every day like I do, I can see a clear difference. It might be slightly different for someone that's just taking a look at an Escape for the first time, or the 2017 Escape for the first time and are not really that familiar with the previous 2016s. The model in today's review is a titanium. So it is the top of the line trim package for the Ford Escapes. Now the new 2017 Fusion is coming in a platinum. That will not be happening for the Escapes. The titanium is still the top trim. As every Ford has a capless fuel tank system. No messing around with a cap or getting smelly fingers from gasoline and so on. Just very convenient. Love that with my own car. Ford is the only brand, or they're not the only brand anymore, but they're the brand that holds the patent for that feature. So all the Fords and Lincolns have it. I think some of the Chevys are starting to use it now as well. and I've heard that some Acuras use it as well. It's just a very nice feature. But moving along here, we're going to take a look at the key fob. And something that surprised me a little bit is that they're keeping the old design of the key fob, which is a nice design. I like it. But the new 2017 Fusion is getting a completely new fob. The previous, I'm going to show you my key here. This is the current Ford Fusion fob. And then we have the Escape fob. The only difference between these two, really, except for the design, is that the fob that I have has a light indicator for if the remote start was successful or not, which is a nice feature if you're not looking at your car while you're remote starting it. So that's the only thing that this older fob is missing. So kind of surprised that they're sticking with this fob here, but that might change for the next model year. Who knows? So we're going to take a look at some of the upgrades that the 2017 Escape is getting, whether it's a titanium or an SC or a base model. So the Ford Escape comes in three different engine alternatives. It is the entry level inline four, and then we have the new 1.5 liter EcoBoost, getting a bump in horsepower from the previous 1.6. It now has a 179 horsepower. And then we have this, the 2 liter EcoBoost engine, which now puts out 245 horsepower versus 240 previously, and it has 275 pound-feet of torque versus 270 previously. The Escape Titanium comes with, as I just showed you, the smart key access fob. Put your hand on the door handle and the car unlocks. There's a sensor right here where you can lock the vehicle. Let's step inside and take a look at the new interior. So nothing has really changed here for the, if you see the door. I mean, the panel is the same, pretty soft to the touch. Leather armrest here. Titanium comes with memory seating. But one thing is new here is the interior of the appearance package. This is partial cloth and leather interior. I'd have to say I do like it, but if you are familiar with the Escapes, some of the SCs for the previous model years have this same color interior, so this kind of makes it look like an SC and not a titanium, but that is obviously a matter of opinion. I do like it. Does it look as exclusive? Probably not. But this is the appearance package. It is supposed to look sportier, so that is most likely the reason why they have this interior. Now for the steering wheel. Steering wheel is an upgrade as well. It's the same steering wheel as in the newer Ford Focuses. I mean, I like the steering wheel. I like the older one as well. There's some new features here that we're going to go over. You have your light switches right here, turned all the way to the right. For automatic lights, come on automatically when it gets dark outside, and they stay off when it's daylight. You have a fog lamp, light or button right there, your tailgate, and then interior dimming. So we got push button start, put your foot on the brake. Sync 3 was available for the 2016 model as well. The Escape and the Fiesta were actually the first models to get Sync 3. I have a separate video doing a tutorial of this system here. I'm going to have a link that pops up on the screen right now if you want to do a more in-depth tour of the Sync 3 system. But just to show you here real quick, you have a menu bar down here that is always available. So click audio to get to the audio section where you have AM, FM, Sirius, CD and Bluetooth and so on. Go straight to the phone. Now this Ford Escape right here has navigation, which is it is equipped with. If you click right there in my tutorial video, that specific car does not have navigation. So I can show you real quick here. You can either zoom out with that button right there, or you can pinch, kind of like a smart tablet or a smartphone. Also, there's a swiping mechanism like that. So it's just a very user-friendly system, very, very responsive buttons, which I love. Makes it a little different than the previous My4 Touch. Backup camera is on the 8-inch screen. Got guidance lines. Now to move on to the center stack here, beneath the touchscreen, this is new right here, this design. Again, it's sharing it with the Focus. I do like the outlay of these buttons a little better. They're more accessible. Previously, the gear shifter lever was in the way for the climate buttons right here. So it's more accessible now. And as you can, as you might be able to tell, if you currently have an Escape, the design right here for the cup holders is different as well. Heated seats right here, both sides, dual climate control. And by the way, for the 2017 model year, dual climate control is standard even on an SC, not just a titanium, which is a nice feature. We also have start-stop technology now. You can turn it off or you can have it on. Basically what that means is if you're out driving and you come to a complete stop and have the brake down, the engine will shut off to save fuel. The fan and the radio will stay on, but we will be taking a look at that here when we go on the test drive. There's not much difference in size in the new Ford Escape. Pretty much the same dimensions. The Bliss system is a blind spot monitoring system. You have a light that comes on right here whenever you have a car in your blind spot that you can't see. That system has been around for a while, but it is very helpful. So moving on to the steering wheel here. New design, and one new feature for 2017 that is available that was previously not available is adaptive cruise control. So you can basically set a gap to the car in front of you on the highway and set a speed, obviously, as well. If the car ahead of you slows down, this Ford Escape will slow down as well to keep the same distance in front of the car, or to keep the same distance to the car in front of you. Very nice, especially if you travel a lot and you're on the highway. Adaptive cruise control is an awesome feature. Also new for this year, you have paddle shifters behind the steering wheel, where you can use the 6-speed select shift automatic transmission, put it in the sport mode, and shift manually. So you can see right there, when the car is stationary, it can only shift between two gears. Also, we have ambient lighting. It'll light up in the cup holders, in your door handles, and also down on the floor, which can be controlled by that button on the touchscreen right there. You don't really see any of the lighting unless it is dark outside. Tachometer and speedometer has gotten a slight facelift as well, but the screen in the middle is the same. It's controlled by these buttons right here on the left side of the steering wheel. Basically, you have all kinds of information here. This screen is nice because it's showing you four types of information, which is upper left is your trip meter, To the right, you have average miles per gallon. This is a brand new car. Obviously, it gets more than 3.3 miles per gallon. Bottom left is your instant fuel economy while you're out driving. And then you have how many miles you have to an empty tank. If you scroll down, you got a digital speedometer, trip odometer, and so on. Click to the left, trip meters, information, settings. Same setup as the previous Ford Escape. And then we have the buttons on the right side of the steering wheel. You have your voice activation button, volume.
Please say a command.
Sirius 53.
Tuning to channel 53.
Very capable voice activation prompts as well. Now these buttons are the same as well for the sunroof. So you click this button right here. For the shade, and you open up the sunroof with that button right there. I'm going to close that for now and keep the shade open. So let's step outside the car here and take a look at some of the room in the back. So this is my seating position. I'm 6'2". That's how I would be driving. And this is the leg room you would have. Sitting behind me. So as you can see here, it's a little tight. Ford chooses to have a little cut-in section here to help with knee room. But yes, it is a little tight. But I do fit though. Now, headroom is definitely tight. Seats in the back, they recline. And they also fold down flat by pushing this button here first for the headrest. Pull this lever right here. So you got great cargo space here in the 2017 Ford Escape. Obviously, it comes with the kicking motion for the lift gate. That's been around for a few years. Hit that button right there to close it. And one interesting side note is that you can actually set the height of the tailgate. So let's say you have a short garage or you're just vertically challenged and you can't reach, you can set the tailgate to never go higher than, say, this height right here, or lower, which is a nice feature. Pulled it all the way up. As you can see here, good cargo capacity. We have a cargo shade as well. So you can hide all your personal groceries. Close that. Same dual exhaust tips as the previous model of the Ford Escape. I do like the redesign. I didn't really mind the design of the older Escapes either, but this is one of the most sold SUVs in its class in America. Keeps battling for the top spot with the Honda CR-V. A walk you around here so you can get a full view of the new design of the Ford Escape. As I mentioned, this is a titanium. It has an appearance package on it. That's why you have the black accents as the black wheels. Black right here. You have black side rails and a black grille. Obviously, you can get an Escape that does not have this specific design here, but I do like it. We got two Escapes in here, so I'm gonna actually walk you over to a white one that we have as well, which is an SC, so you can see the difference. We're actually gonna drive over there. Show you here, we have the electronic parking brake. Put your foot on the brake and you pull up. Activate, and then you just push down to deactivate. In the armrest, whoops, we have a USB port down there and a 12 volt as well. Cubbies here, so this midsection here is new, and as I mentioned already, I do like it. Previously, the gear shifter lever was in the way of changing the climate and stuff. You had to kind of put it in drive to be able to have full access here. Now you have buttons for the heated seats. Before, you had these little turn knobs sitting right there. Obviously, being a titanium, you get the Sony stereo system. 390 watts, 10 speakers. Good sound system. And also you have the universal garage door opener. Vanity mirrors with lights. Every woman loves that, I know that. All right, so taking off in the 2017 Ford Escape. I'm gonna take it for a little longer drive here, obviously, but I'm gonna pull up here and show you guys the SC trim level of the Escape. We actually got two new ones. Well, look at that. Pulling up right here. So let's pull it in, take a look at the backup camera. I do like these black accents here as well. That's new. And I'm not 100% sure, but most likely that is because this has the appearance package. Got a little black chrome strip looking thing around the air vents. Nice as well. And just so you know, you got your CD player right here. All right, let's step outside. So, the appearance package versus the regular SC. We have one of our detail guys over there. Apologize the noise. Yeah, this one is locked, as you might be able to see. It has a regular cloth interior. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to jump back inside and take it for a spin. The only thing missing in this 2017 Ford Escape as we take it out on the road is the lack of a performance-based engine. It doesn't have to be, you know, a quarter-mile race or anything like that, but the engine that is in this Escape here is the same engine as I have in my Fusion. I mentioned already it's the 2-liter four-cylinder EcoBoost engine. It's got 240 horsepower and 270 pound-feet of torque. Now, as I also mentioned already, is that it has the start-stop technology. So right now, I have my foot on the brake, I'm sitting at a red light, the engine is completely shut off. The air conditioner is still blowing, and the radio still works. And as we take off here again, as soon as I get a green light, take my foot off the brake, and the engine will start right up. I don't know if you guys noticed that. Turn the, let's see here, so we don't have any, have my foot on the brake. I'm gonna release it right now, and it starts right up. It's very quick, it's a very smooth transition. And it is to help with fuel economy. Interesting side note is though that this Ford Escape here, maybe it's because of weight, is actually rated at 1 mile less per gallon on the highway. So don't really know what they're thinking there with the auto start stop technology. I know in the 2.7 EcoBoost that's in the F-150s, that feature is there to help with fuel economy. It doesn't really seem to help with fuel economy here. Either way, it's a good system. You still get good fuel economy. 27 on the highway is pretty good for an SUV, especially with the power that this car has. I mean, if you really stomp on it, it does scoot. And I don't think there's many SUVs in its class out there that has more power than a Ford Escape, along with the good gas mileage. Like the Honda CR-V, for instance, they just have an inline four. At least the Tucson has a turbocharged engine, and I'm not an expert on all the other brands. I do know that the Escape, though, with its three engine alternatives, is up there when it comes to diversifying and what you're looking for in your car. So again, at a red light, the engine is shut off. Green light, turns right back on. So it is a very smooth transition. Now, we're driving down a windy road here. For some of you that follow all of my reviews, you know I drive down this road pretty much on every review I do, because it's windy, it's called Snake Hill. Let's see how this Escape sits on the road. Obviously a little body roll, but what are you gonna, it's actually a lot. Medium. But it is a very comfortable car to drive. It's not a performance car, so you're gonna have that, some body roll. But I do like driving this car. It is nice. If it came with a more powerful engine, I would actually consider maybe getting an Escape, because it is a nice car. And you get a little more room than in my current Fusion. And with this appearance package, I gotta say, it looks pretty cool. Seating position in the Ford Escape. I like the seats. They're comfortable. They're bolstered, but just enough. Again, this is not a performance car. This type of vehicle, people want comfort. And a guy my size, 6'2", I am very comfortable. The Ford Escape is known to have the seat go up really, really high. So for me, yeah, I'm definitely getting squished here. So for anyone, no matter what size you are, you'll be comfortable in the Ford Escape, especially someone that is shorter. A lot of women that I talk to in my work environment love how high up the seat goes in the Ford Escape, and also how far forward you get it. Steering wheel, won't be able to see that from that angle, but the telescopes, and tilts, obviously. So any kind of position that you need to be comfortable in, you can get it in the 2017 Ford Escape. So let me know, what do you guys think of the new 2017 Ford Escape and its upgrades? Do you like them or do you not like them? Do you like the previous model better? And if there was anything that I missed in this review, please let me know. If you have any further questions, let me know in the comments section below. And if this is your first time checking out the channel, browse it, watch some of the other videos. If you like them, hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.